Wholesale Club. Here we are looking for our front row. There it is, the GJ Gardner Holmes Whanganui Toyota, the high-flying man out there, the 55 of Jaden Carrick. A lot of people, Jaden will be a new rider, yes indeed. I think only did his debut 600 season last year, but comes hot out of the Super Motards. So nice to see, and the biggest rider's got points up. 91 for Johnny Ross and Tony Summers on the 16. Keen just to look at that, because of course Toby took the win yesterday and had his first ever win. Man, we had some days of first. Toby Summers' first ever Supersport 600 National Championship win yesterday, and of course Scott Moyer's first ever win in Superbikes as well. So what a memorable day it was here last year. Of course, here we got the win to Craig Cherris, and the crowd went wild over that one, and that was only his second ever win in Superbikes as well. So there's something about Levels Track that gives us a few of these records, and hopefully a few more of them will be shattered here today. So Timaru Yamaha, Supersport 600 to get away, and of course today we have 15 lappers. Yesterday they were only 10, so we've gone to 15 lappers. Take a note of that, folks. So although we used to have 220 lappers on a day, we've now got three different races, 10, 15 and 15 respectively. So a good race duration. The 10 yesterday, a lot of people saying they're just really getting into the race by about that 9th or 10th lap, and here it is coming to a halt. So that 15 today, Spider, just making it a little bit tougher for them, so we're certainly going to see a true champion. Let's get ready for the update here at lap number one.
Oh, 55 got a fly over starting. There he goes, probably 40, 50 metres. Number 55, long knees, Jaden Kay. Toby Summers, first visit to this track, and he's sitting there in a good solid second place, but he won't settle for second. And the New Zealand champion, current New Zealand champion, and winner of several races so far this season in the Super Sport 600 class, John Ross on the Repsol Suzuki there in fifth. Al Hoogenboezem, 43, and then we've got a Wolfpack racing bike, and that looks like Dan Menon with Reese Holmes is moving up the field now. Who will ever forget last year at Timaru? Reese moved from eighth through to first place on the second race. First one was wet and run by Seth Devereux, but Reese moved from eighth till first place, and then his tyres went off, slipped down to fourth, and on the last lap, out of sight of the commentators, but inside of the, at the north end of the track, and inside of the spectators, the front three guys, two of them went down and one went off the track, so Reese was gifted a win there, but he got up there from eighth to first place. That's how hot this class. Look at that freight train. Still the same three suspects in the front, but Jaden Carrick's not got away as far as he did on the last lap. It's Summers on the Summers Plumbers, R&R Power Sports Yamaha R6. In second place, of course, John Ross and Al Hoogenboezem, 43. But here we go, that big pack of riders, and Seth Devereux amongst that as well on the bright green Kawasaki. Jeremy Holmes said he had a shit of a day yesterday, got balked at the start. He's got the pace, but he's amongst that pack of five or six. 15 lapper, remember, 15 lapper.
James Hoogenboezem, Adam Chambers and Ashley Payne will join in there. Ashley Payne, teammate of Jaden Carrick, and Ashley didn't do the earlier two rounds of the Suzuki Series, but opted, of course, had to do his home Whanganui Cemetery Circuit event, but said he was putting all his resources in coming down here to look out for him. He's got the support of Sprockets NZ and a nicely presented Supersport in there as well. So look out for Whanganui's Ashley Payne. He's pitted down the first straight here as well, along with his GJ Gardner Holmes Whanganui Toyota mate and Jaden Carrick. So two good Whanganui characters. You won't hear a lot or see a lot of these guys. They work under the radar, though. You're all-time cool Kiwi competitors, so great to see. There you go, looking out for the update from the front, and no change in there at the moment. In fact, if anything, I'd say Jaden Carrick might have just pushed himself out a couple of bike lengths again. That looks a bit better from his point of view, because Toby had drawn, and they look to be about equal. The gap from first to second to third. But they've just had that little bit of a buffer in favour of Jaden. Love the ride there by Alistair. Well done. Now we've got Reese Holmes to come through. Look at that from Seth. Yes, moving up. Seth Devereux. He's gone past Daniel Medham. So good work from Seth Devereux. In fact, now it's Jeremy Holmes. So Daniel has gone back one. Oh, in fact, he's gone past the two of them. That's why. So Daniel Medham wasn't there. So it's now moving up. And Seth Devereux, Jeremy Holmes. We've got James Hoogenboezem, Adam Chambers, Ashley Payne in there. What about young Aaron Hassan? I think that's just a great story as well, that we've seen him moving into this class. He's come out of the 125s, going to the 600. That's a huge step up for young Aaron. So well done with Cameron Hudson in there and Avalon Biddle. And poor Avalon, of course, crashes on the Friday at both Ruapuna and now again here at Levels. So really starting to knock herself around. But Spider, we had the privilege of seeing her in action at that second round at Whanganui of the Suzuki Series. And I think we saw the best of Avalon Biddle.
Oh, definitely, and to see her out leading a race of that level. There was a few of the championship players not there, but there was most of them were there in that, and Avalon there in the bright orange leathers out there in the front for a brief period of time. Fastest man on the track, Toby Summers. He's reeling in Jaden Carrick. Now, Jaden's a, both these guys are former Motard. Well, when I say former Motarders, they both still play on Motard bikes, so they've used to the bikes sliding around under them, and good buddies as well. Glenn Hayden's the man behind Dino Lab and Whanganui, and he prepares the bike for 55, the 55 machine of Jaden Carrick, and he's also a Motard. But this year he decided not to go Motard racing and be the pit boy for Jaden, and that just shows you how good, and what an amazing man on the Dino Lab. That's the bike preparation for number 55, Jaden Carrick.
And also a point to add to with young Glenn is that he's going to become a fireman. They only select 30 a year every year as new firemen in New Zealand. They get about 600 applicants, so it's something, a very prestigious career for a young guy. He's aimed on that, and there was no way he could afford to have any injury. So great story behind Glenn Hayden, former New Zealand mountain bike downhill champion as well, and then he all of a sudden he turned up on the moto scene and realised, hey, he was from Whanganui, might as well go motarding, because that is the motard capital, more motarders per head of population than any other city in the country, and the rest of the show is history with him. Now I'm doing some great bike engineering, but here we are with the bike play out there in 55.77, and looking back there to the number one of John Ross, they still look about the same, and it's Jaden Carrick still with the best time at 104.929, remembering that record as Nick Cole rightly pointed out yesterday, it's 104.000, so almost 1 second faster than what we're seeing out there at the moment from Jaden.
Yeah, unfortunately, I miscommentated yesterday. I was reading the Super Stock lap record and said all these three guys had done lap records during the race, but that was my error. But what was important is all these three guys had the fastest lap, and we've seen Toby Summers there in second spot with the fastest lap. It is indeed the only man in the fours, Jaden Carrick, on the G.J. Gardner Holmes Pirelli Shod number 55 out there in the front. He's the fastest man on the track, and that big battle on for fourth, fifth and sixth. It's Al Hoogenboosem, Reese Holmes, Dan Medham's moved up over, and Jeremy Holmes, Adam Chambers, Seth Devereaux on the Kawasaki, James Hoogenboosem, Cameron Hudson, Ashley Payne, Avalon Biddle, Aaron Hassan, Shane Richardson on number 28, Nathan Diprose, Andrew Evans, Rick Smincher and Dylan Jeffrey. Now Dylan had a big crash last weekend, was sidelined. His mother rung up and says, you're coming home. He says, no, I'll be alright for next weekend. I said to him last night, you were last. I wasn't being offensive. No, somebody else crashed. I said, but you're last on the track, but there's no first, there's no last. And that family, Father Graham, they're absolutely having a ball here following the New Zealand Superbike Championships. That's what we need. There's no firsts if there's no lasts. So still with the bat. Second place is moving up there. Number 77, Neil.
Yeah, great to see indeed, and take an opportunity to talk about Andrew Evans as well, supported by Derby Z and Templeton out of Christchurch. And Andrew, a break of 5 years out of the sport, he's just loving being back in the sport. I think it's the next story. So well done, Rick Minson. Now always enjoying Rick's on a racetrack. Rick's has moved up to 70. Well done, Rick's. Now here's the story of an older guy that got the bug for motorcycle road racing, and he's got this on his bucket list. He's never been to these circuits before in his life, and he wants to do this before he has any thought of finishing up in his road racing. A short time on a bike, but a good time on a bike. Now, here's Shane Richardson, got his first ever championship points yesterday, 40th place, so he got 2 points. He's running in 15th at the moment. He's going to get one for his performance out there at the moment, but I said to him earlier today, I'll settle on 4 points from him. I want him to do it again and again, but he has slipped back one place there at the moment. But here we go with our freight train, and Toby closing it down. Toby has, in fact, he got the fastest lap that time. No, he hasn't. Still at Jaden Carrick, 104.929, so almost a second outside the record of Nick Cole here for 600. So Jaden Carrick, Toby Summers, John Ross. What about Alistair Hoogenboosem? He has always been fourth, and he's been a good margin behind third, but he's way in front of fifth as well. I'll call him the loneliest rider. He's the loneliest man on the racetrack. The awesome excellence of Al Hoogenboosem. That is a great ride from Alistair. Look how good he is out there at the moment on the Suzuki, Dunlop, Revit, Clive Barrington Construction, Race Supply, Shots, Arcade Chains, Elf Oils, Pizzazz, supported bike. So well done, Alistair, or Al as he gets known as. So great performance there by Al, because he is clearly the best of the rest by far. But that next battle still with Reese Holmes, Jeremy Holmes, Adam Chambers. Unfortunately, Seth Devereaux was at the sharp end of that group. I think about sixth place. He slipped back now to be in 10th. Not enough rain today for Seth. We know he's a wet track specialist, proved it here last year. We're talking about those one-offs before Spider, about what happened last year with the likes of Craig Sheriffs, and what happened here yesterday with Scott, and also with the win in this one to Toby. But of course last year, as you rightly point out, Seth Devereaux in his first 600 win, and so too for Reese Holmes. So I'll tell you what, that's been effectively the last three of the last four races in the 600 class about a brand new winner here at Level. Something about this place, I love it. It's got an atmosphere, it's a special track, and it really is a rider's track, because you've got to work for your ride out there. It doesn't become what I call a checkbook track. You don't have to have the fastest bike to be on the winner's podium here, as Seth Devereaux well proved here last year. So great works in this Timaru Yamaha sponsored Super Sport 600. Jaden Carrick, I tell you what, yesterday we saw he went to the front spider and he had a little bit of a buffer, but that got reeled and he ended up back in third place in the end. But I tell you what, even though Toby's trying and you can see him try, all of a sudden Jaden says, well, I'll just try a little bit harder. He's staying enough in front of him.
Oh, certainly. Just looking at the fastest laps, the first three guys set their fastest lap on the third lap. It's now lap eight. But looking further down the pack, Adam James and Cameron Hudson have both set their fastest lap, as indeed has Ashley Payne on lap eight. So that means the mid-pack is compressing. Last weekend we saw a wet race for one of the 600 race. And in three laps, John Ross went out on wets. In three laps, he had a massive 18 seconds lead. Three of the four guys that started from pit lane opted to go and get some wet weather tyres on. They got up to second, third and fourth, and eventually Seth Dedrow for coming for a win just narrowly pipped John Ross. So an 18 second lead within three laps was just absolutely unbelievable, but it was all about tyre choice and of course the skill there. Reece Holmes getting nibbled on the home show. Reece Holmes is slowed up, or is Jeremy Holmes side by side down the straight? Jeremy's come out of the slipstream early. Reece is trying for that outside line at the end of the front straight. Reece on the John Two Hoy sponsored machine has got it, but this won't stay that way for very long at all.
I tell you what, that's six laps to go. Jeremy Holmes' bike is a beautiful new bike. It's a newer bike. They reckon it's missing about 20 horsepower on the last bike. There's still a lot of preparation to do with it, but always enjoyed Jeremy. The ultimate professional, of course, had the crash here last year, but man, he had a real spark to his racing last year. But now with that new bike, as you well know, you don't turn him into a race bike in just a matter of one or two meetings. So he's obviously getting better. The preparation working behind the scenes. And this Southland Honda team, they're the loveliest team in the pits, folks. They are so, so nice. So get him behind young Jeremy. And we love Southland Honda as well. Proud to be behind the Burt Munro and many other great events. And they'll be disappointed, like so many, that we won't be racing at Invercargill next weekend. But hey, folks, you can have the day off and maybe a barbie at home. We'll come around Saturday night instead.
James Hoogenboosen there, and having a good solid ride in 11th place as well on Bike 85, one of the four Hoogenboosens running this weekend. But we'll go out to that pack there, and it was Reece Holmes got back in front at the end of the front straight. Jeremy Holmes is going to do the same thing, almost emerge in the last lap, leaves it till a bit later to try and pull out. Will he get up on the inside? He's done it. Wow, four or five bike lengths. It looked almost like the Reece Holmes went wide a bit, but that wasn't for lack of trying.
And that's against the spider. I put it down to it not pulling out of that slipstream. A lot of the other guys have been pulling out too early. He then had the slingshot and he hit the advantage. He made it stick, so well done. That's been dust to fly at the bottom end. Didn't see that, didn't see where it is. It's the other side of the wall. There we go, a bit of dust. Now we'll maybe have to find out with the process of elimination. Are we missing anybody from this next group? We've still got Al all on his own here, that's fine. And we've still got five in here. Oh, down we go there, though. There's one to go straight.
That's Reece Holmes, I think. That's Reece Holmes right. Going down.
Yeah. Oh, how good is that? It will be very little damage.
He's up.
He'll be okay.
Oh, that's a tough one. Yeah. We've got a yellow flag at the end of the track. Dramas are plenty. In fact, I'm looking for my binoculars because I don't know who that is. We won't keep on going, but wow, 3-1 lap for 600s. Last weekend in the wet race, we had everybody finish, which was outstanding.
We're missing Seth Devereaux, so I'm going to put the dust down to Seth Devereaux, Spider. There's the update. Seth Devereaux missing. I'll put the dust down to him. Of course, that dirt and Seth don't go together because he's a wet weather fan. I'm going to put it down to Seth. Please, it's not to say it definitely is, far from it, but that's just the process of elimination. As Reece has gone over to that John Tuhoy racing bike and looking at its AOK, I tell you what, that was a beautiful slide, a classic front end out, and he was so lucky the way it went down, and he of course followed it. Was lucky it was no high side, far from it, the low side, and the bike just goes out. They're the best crashes to ever have, and the bike has just skidded down the side. Would have worn a little bit off. We saw the sparks fly, but the great news is it didn't catch fire. And in fact, by the time the bike had slowed up, I don't know whether it actually even hit the wall. I don't know whether it was very close to it, but there'd be minimal damage. So hope to see him back on a racetrack with a re-scrutinied bike in that next routing. He'd be so disappointed. Think of the glory he had here last year. So gutting.
Oh, that disappointment sitting over on the tyre wall at Castle Corner is Jaden Carrick. Jaden Carrick's the one that went down there. Jaden Carrick, the race leader, number 55. He'll be gutted, but the important thing, he's up and running. So he was getting away too. He was getting away, but that's handed the lead. The lead's gone to John Ross. John Ross, we didn't notice that. There was so much drama with dust flying in three parts of the track.
I'm just wondering whether, because we'd watched Toby get up too close to him, I think Toby probably had to take an evasive action to miss Jaden in hindsight, and that's why it's given it to John Ross. But hey, that's what racing's all about. So what's that? Four riders down. Four, I think, down during the race today. So, I tell you what, to more drama than Shortland Street's got an entire year. All unfolds right here at Levels, the home of South Canterbury Motorcycle Club, round two of our Bridgestone showy and Motorcycle Trader News supported New Zealand Superbike Road Race Championship. There's your race leader, number one, the Repsol Suzuki, and a great ride. And it just keen to see where there's Toby, he's back a little bit. Toby's there, the others were lappers, so Toby for that second place should be Al. There he is, beautiful ride. Al Hoogerboom deserving his place on the podium for a third here at the moment. And look at this now with Jeremy Holmes, much better from Jeremy. This is a great ride, fourth place and fighting back, so look out for Jeremy Holmes. He's been cutting his way through there. Daniel Medham through all of that as well, Spider. We've seen the up and downs of the other, and Daniel Medham showing some real good launchy stuff out there, and I'm pleased with that. I actually thought that Adam Chambers might have had the advantage over him because Adam had seen that bit better prepared from the Suzuki series, but young Daniel has come down here with a fresh head on his shoulders, and he's just saying, I'm all part of this, and going for it as they head down towards John Jones. And right in there is Wolfpack teammate in Adam Chambers, followed by Cameron Hudson. Look at that for a consistent result. That is awesome. There he is, folks, the number 16. What a ride out there. So Cameron, well done. The Christchurch man on the race supplies, Metzler, Forbes and Davey, Trevor Pierce, Yamaha, Warren Aerials and Telephones and Budget Motorcycle Spares. Cameron Hudson, go you champion.
Oh, yeah. Incredible, too. John Ross has set his fastest lap on lap 10, and he's got about 4 or 5 seconds lead over and above Toby Summers, but he has now dipped into the four, so he's up the ante. He's settled down there. He will be able to see that Jaden Carrick, the early race leader, in fact, most of the race leader, is parked up on the side there at Castrol. Head down, arse up, and Toby's got no answer for this at the moment. Toby seems to be slipping back, mind you. I said that John Ross had set his fastest lap on lap 10, so it is John Ross, Toby Summers, Alistair Hoogenboosum, Jeremy Holmes, Dan Medham, Adam Chambers, Cameron Hudson, Aaron Hassan, James Hoogenboosum, Ashley Payne, Avalon Biddle, Shane Richardson on 28, Nathan Diprose, Rex Muncher, Andrew Evans, Dylan Jeffries, and of course we've had those three guys out, Jaden Carrick, Seth Devereaux and Reese Holmes, all on the same lap too.
Rex Muncher and Andrew Evans, in fact, talking about on the same laps yesterday, Spider, I think there's some openness in talking about the fact that a rider was excluded yesterday because they'd come in the superbike class but they clearly missed the 115% cut and missed it by 10 seconds, so there was the right kind of thing in doing that. So if anybody's involved in his team, I say congratulations for your acceptance, because that's meaning that, as Tony Rees has been pointing out, the likes of Cemetery Circuit in Formula 1, no lapping going on in the race at all, Spider, because that's the quality of all those top riders being up there, so it's just reduced the drama and chances of an incident. Oh, checkered, there we go, checkered.
And, look at that, checkered flag, and John Ross runs off at the end of its main straight. He's upright or out, but checkered flag, we missed the checkered flag.
And how was Toby Summers disappointed when he went across the line there? He was showing his anxiety, he threw his head backwards and forwards, and he just knew his disappointment, because he had the win yesterday, needed to get those points back, because John Ross already 21 points in front, 21 points, so that's only now extended the lead for John, and he knows that he had to start to reel that back in and wanted to win here today. But Al Hoogenboosum on the podium, just loving that, well done for that third place, great performance out there. Jeremy Holmes, that was just sensational for the fourth place, much improved with the Daniel Medham, Adam Chambers. How about that for Honda? Got to say, well done. Suzuki, Yamaha, Suzuki, Honda. With Cameron Hudson, Aaron Hassan, with James Hoogenboosum, Ashley Payne. Avalon Biddle got to the 11th. Shane Richardson in 12th. Now, I said to Shane, 2 points yesterday, first ever national championship points. I said, hey, another four today. I'll tell you what, he's got all of those in one race. So well done, Shane. But I hope he can do that again. Nathaniel DePros, Rex Mintzer, 14th. 2 points, Rex. We love you. Body Fuel Cafe man out of Taupo. You got to meet this guy, folks. A real nice guy to be involved in our sport, and a guy that's ticking his bucket list. That's why he's here. So I've got to do a national championship. Yeah, he does club racing, and he says, hey, I'm going to do it. I'll tell you what, more than his bucket is now gold plated because it's got national points tagged to it. And what about that Andrew Evans, the fight back on the Derby supported 600, and he gets the extra points. And Dylan Jeffries, good story you're talking about, Spider. He just misses out by a point, but hey, I'd say by the next one he'll be able to fight his way back. Looking from here, it looks to be as if our incidences have not been too major. Obviously not an ambulance call, and two of the three that we've watched have been that their bikes are being pushed back to the finish. Drama in the Timaru Yamaha sponsored Supersport 600. Timaru Yamaha on the Hilton Highway, Washdike, right here at Timaru, with RST, Mitchell and Pirelli, Shoei, Shirai and Berwick. Just some of the quality brands from Timaru Yamaha, the new biggest bike shop in South Canterbury. Proud to bring you Yamaha.
Hey, just looking at the points here. We went into the national points, into this meeting. I'm not going to tell you the points of this race because I can't add that much, but so far we've got John Ross 91, Toby Summers 67, Al Hoogenboosum on 56. Now, that's how they finished on the track this way, so it'll be, the points will have expanded a bit, but we go back to Jeremy Holmes in fourth place, but 5th, 6th and 7th was Jaden Carrick, Seth Devereaux and Reece Holmes. They all crashed in this race, 41, 41, 40. So they're going to just move that whole bracket of 5th, 6th and 7th down the further way. So they'll get no more points. The advantage on that will be James Hooger-Boozle and Avalon Biddle and Adam Chambers moving up there. So that's where the points sit. The three winners, the three leaders of the championship are out there in the front, and those three crashes all on the same lap, I think it pretty well was, and what dramas we have in the 600 Supersport, mate, and that's only the first race of the day.